Hello, 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 hello. Sweet. Thank you for being here to watch us on Artist Picks. The company is Live&Breathing. I am Justin Glanville, your host. And I hear an echo of this show happening, and it just distracted me. I'm very sorry.
Two rooms at once.
Yeah. Next to me, if you're a fan of Live&Breathing and you pay attention to what we're doing, you might be surprised that I'm the host, because normally she's the host of our other show. Her name is Jessica Watson, and the show is the Appalachian String Inn. And thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me, Justin.
What's up?
You know, just having a Friday.
It is Friday.
This room that I love so much.
Yeah. Oh, this is a cozy spot.
Yeah.
We're going to be back in here this coming Tuesday.
Yep. Just a few days.
Still trying to nail down the lineup of the musicians?
A little bit. I know we've got Greg Horn coming back.
Awesome. He's so goofy.
I know.
I love that guy.
And he's so versatile. He can just do whatever.
Is there anything he doesn't play?
Not that I'm aware.
I don't think I've seen him play a piano yet.
Well, I don't know that I've seen it either, but I bet you can do it.
Challenge. Challenge, Greg, if you're out there.
Yeah. We'll get old-time real, piano. We'll get real wacky and have that piano for an old-time tune sometime.
There's a piano over there.
Yeah. Yeah, and Aaron Searcy and Parker Hewitt will be playing fiddle.
Cool.
So still trying to line up that bass player.
Yeah, but, still trying.
We'll get there.
If you play upright,
yep.
Come on by.
Give us a shout.
That show has been so much fun. Do you know how many episodes we did? I was wrong during the last time. I think we're at 9.
I think this will be 9?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Oh, there's my phone. That's rude.
And we took two months off?
I think 2 months off
so
around the holidays.
Like, yeah. We're almost at a
it's
year
cranking.
Of that thing. That's
yeah.
crazy.
Tell me, you taught me a lot about old-time music. I remember, I didn't really have a clear distinction in my head until we started doing the show. I knew that I liked it, but it was blurry. The definition that I had in my head was blurry, and now I feel like I have a much more clear definition of it. Would you like to define it for the audience?
I feel like everyone knows what, everyone has a definition of bluegrass. Everyone knows what bluegrass sounds like.
Uh-huh.
And it's kind of easier for me to sort of compare it to bluegrass music.
Because the instrumentation?
The instrumentation's the same. The sound is, you know, generally the same. The banjo is one of the only things that's kind of, like, the instrument itself is a little different. Like, it doesn't have the resonator.
Uh-huh.
You're not using finger picks, so it has a completely different different approach to that instrument.
And what is that approach called?
Clawhammer.
Yes.
So instead of the three-finger rolls and all the bluegrass, picking style, it's all...
Is clawhammer and drop thumb, is that the same thing?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Or frailing. Some people call it frailing banjo.
Oh, wow.
So, just no picks, all, you know, either first or second finger. People have different ways of doing it, and then dropping that thumb for those other...
It is so complicated.
...notes in between. I remember when I first heard that style, and I was like, I don't understand how those notes are happening on the upbeats.
Yeah.
Where? How?
Yeah.
It's fascinating, and it's so fun, and you get, like, a warmer sound out of the banjo.
Yep. Without those metal picks.
Yeah.
Clanking away on
yeah,
that thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, but other than that, I mean, you know, you've got your fiddles, you've got, which are usually kind of driving the tune,
mm-hmm.
And then guitar, upright bass, you know, there can be mandolin, there can be all kinds of stuff. Sarah Morgan is a lap dulcimer player who's going to be at next month's.
Really?
Oh,
that's so exciting.
Stream. So, yeah.
I haven't seen.
Lined up
is that also called a mountain dulcimer?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So that'll be, yeah, she's amazing. And that's a little more rare to see someone play that
yes,
in a jam.
I like
there just aren't as many people who play that instrument, but she's
when I was in Dahlonega, I don't know if that was probably 20 years even ago, I had never heard of or seen that instrument, and I moved to Dahlonega, and there was a lot of people that played it there.
Yeah.
And I thought that was so interesting.
Yeah.
And then what is the other dulcimer? The one with, it's like a little piano kind of.
Oh, gosh, I don't remember what that's called.
Okay.
But there's also the hammer dulcimer. That's our Irish version. Yeah.
That's Irish?
Well, that's, I hear that mostly in Irish settings.
I recorded an album, The Redeemer Church. Hmm. I don't know if you know Ben Bannister in town. This is a long time ago.
Yeah, okay.
And got to record a bunch of things that I had never recorded before, but I had also never seen a hammer dulcimer. But somebody who's good at it, that is an incredibly impressive instrument to watch, because you're basically playing the drums on a kind of piano.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, the Four Leaf Pete guys in town.
Yes.
Rick Hall's like an amazing hammer dulcimer.
Yeah, oh, I love watching that.
Yeah. Yeah, you got a Four Leaf Pete video on there.
That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
I didn't realize you'd done.
Also worked on one of their albums.
Nice.
I cannot remember the name of it, but I remember working on it with my friend, and we got snowed into this place on the river, on the French Broad River, that I used to stay at in the winter times, and I wrecked my car picking him up from, I want to say the bus station. Yeah, I think he took a bus up from Atlanta. And I drove so carefully, and the snow was really coming down, and I was probably 300 yards from the house, and made it through some crazy turns, did a great job, and then there's this little steep part, and probably 2 miles per hour, slid about 100 feet into a phone pole. There was nothing I could do. It's like, I can't roll. Oh, I was trying to roll and turn, and just I had to go straight.
Oh, that feeling where you're just like,
helpless.
This is it. This is happening.
Yeah.
I hate that.
Hang on, everybody. At 2 miles per hour, just panic.
But yeah, I mean, back to the old time definition. It's also, I'd say one of the biggest differences between old time and bluegrass also is the approach to those tunes.
Mm-hmm.
Because bluegrass tends to be more like showcasing people throughout, kind of like a jazz form where you present the melody for the tune,
mm-hmm.
and then you're like, all right, fiddle solo,
yeah,
guitar solo, mandolin
everybody
solo,
gets
whatever,
around.
Everyone gets a break.
Yeah.
You don't really have that in old time, which is kind of what I love about it, because I don't love taking solos over stuff.
Yeah.
So it's more about finding a groove together in the group. And there can be variations, and you can do harmonies with the melody and all this other stuff, but you're not really taking breaks.
How long have you played clawhammer?
I started when I was at MTSU, so that would have been in 2007.
Okay, wow.
Yeah.
You're awesome at it.
Thank you.
I love watching you play.
I've played guitar most of my life, but
was that your first instrument?
Yeah, but clawhammer banjo really feels kind of like home to me now. I'm like, it just feels great. Yeah.
I worked for the Abbott Brothers, and we have a very wild banjo player. He usually uses picks. Kind of wishes it was an electric guitar, but. He has also, I've watched him learn clawhammer.
Yeah.
I mean, clawhammer. And through the years of him, how uncomfortable it was to get him to like drop that thumb.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, it's been many years of watching him. Now he's very fluid with it. And I hope to have him on the show sometime. He's also a fan of the show. He really loves watching it. But just watching the progression, and like at one point, like, it kind of clicked. Like, it was just like you could see him like forcing it kind of. And then after, I mean, it was a while, but then it was just like the rhythm, and it just started to happen. And then everything else kind of fell in place on it. Because he already knew what to do with this hand.
Right. I mean, it's all, you know, you're relying a lot more on open strings for banjo, for that style especially. So there's a lot more like hammer-ons and pull-offs and stuff. But if you've played other, you know, fretted instruments.
Yeah.
Left hand is like, okay, I get it.
Yeah.
The right hand, I mean, I remember it took me a while, and it I do feel like there was a moment for me too where it just made sense.
Yeah.
It felt natural. It's like, because for a while you're just like reminding yourself, okay, bum diddy, bum diddy, bum diddy. And then as soon as you start finally landing your thumb on that fifth string, it's like, okay, now you have to drop your thumb. What? No, that's too much. So it's like, it doesn't make sense at first. And then just doing it over and over and over. And eventually it does feel like you're just drumming on that.
Yeah.
On that.
That's such a cool rhythm.
Yeah. It's just finding that rhythm, keeping that hand moving to the beat. It's super fun.
Love it.
Yeah.
Do we want to go into the first video?
Sure. Yeah.
This video is one of my favorite videos that we've ever recorded, because there's these times where you get these musicians that they haven't played that much together.
Mm-hmm.
And in this circumstance, I don't think that they had ever all played together. And in the mix is this cello player, Rashad, who is, I don't know how to describe this man. He is one of a kind.
Yeah.
His energy is out of this world. The one thing, I had seen him play before in a couple other bands and been around him before. I do not know him that well. He probably would not recognize me at all. But I remember, so this video was shot at the Pump House in Pickathon, which we've talked about. It's a little 9x9 cinder block, tiny room. There's two windows, a door, and then there's a stovepipe in one corner. So we mounted a camera to a stovepipe and then used those other two openings to get the shots. Very tricky space. But also, you know, late night, as in most festivals, there's jams. And so we had this late night spot, and there was this jam going on, and I hear this doo-doot, doo-doot, and it's going on, and I look, and it's him, and he wears that, you'll see the hat, I don't know what that style of Peter Pan hat, I don't know what you call it, but I see that, and he's in the darkness of the woods, circling this jam, going doo-doot, doo-doot, and he's getting closer and closer, and he picks up the tempo, and then he's like in the key of the jam, and it's doo 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 doo, and then all of a sudden, like, he's in the jam just shredding,
man.
And I've never seen anything like it, but it was amazing. And so leading into this video, you can clearly see his energy is driving this performance.
Absolutely.
And some people are kind of like trying to hang on, and some people are just like, this is awesome, and everybody nails it, and is
Bruce
such a...
Bruce is just having a great time.
Yeah, he really is. He really is.
He's very smiley through this one.
Do you want to introduce the video?
Sure. Yeah, this is, talking about old-time music, a lot of it's not notated. Most of it's learned by ear. Luckily, there are a lot of great videos floating around on the internet now for really nice arrangements of tunes, and that's a great source for learning new tunes. This is one that I send to people a lot when I'm like, hey, let's learn this tune, Chinkapin Hunting. And this is always the video that I send. Like, let's see if we
Does
can
it scare
do
him away?
Anything that sounds like this version of Chinkapin Hunting.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So this is a Bruce Molskey band playing Chinkapin Hunting.
You wish for Chinkapin Hunting!
One, two, three,
Thank you.
Man, that's a bundle of energy in there.
It's so good.
Oh, I love that one. That is definitely one of my favorite videos.
Never gets old.
Paul Tucci, thanks for chiming in. Auto harp. Yep.
That's the one.
It's pretty similar. It's like I think you hold it like this, right?
Yeah, I think it's more
like a chess piano.
Yeah.
Well, you strum, but you also like chord with buttons.
Right.
So not like a piano.
I've never tried it.
Ugh.
But it's a great sound.
Don't want to tune one, I'll tell you that.
No, not so much. I mean, I feel like I could tune my banjo all day long and it would never really be in tune.
Hey, but actually, it might be a step up from tuning a banjo. Oh, banjo joke.
Wow, banjos.
You want to exchange banjo jokes?
Oh, what do you got?
I got why should you never leave your car unlocked with your banjo in the back seat?
Why?
Because you come back and it'll be full of banjos.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
No, my friend, Kenzo told me this joke.
Okay.
What do lawyers and crap.
I already love it.
Crap, I can't even, I'm going to get it wrong.
You want a second? I've got one.
Yeah.
This has actually really happened. Okay, first off, most terrifying moment of my life. I want to put that out there. It was terrible, but accidents happened. A few months ago, I slipped and fell down the stairs holding my infant and fractured his skull. He is fine.
Oh, good.
Baby's heel. Yeah. It was the most, it was a terrible moment.
Sure. Yeah.
But in talking to this with people and other parents and whatnot, I got everybody's very supportive. You know, these things happen. Very similar things happened to a few people that I talked to, and their kids are very successful in college and whatnot. So, anywho, but the best thing that I think one of our mutual friends responded was like, oh, don't be surprised if he becomes a banjo player.
Oh,
so sorry.
Brutal.
I know, so sorry.
No, the lawyer one is what banjos and lawyers have in common. Most people prefer it when the case is closed.
Oh, that's a good one. I have not heard that one.
There was for a while, over at WDVX, they had like their little bulletin board thing, and there was a flyer up there that had little pull-off tabs. And the flyer was like, do you want to learn to play the banjo? And it was like a little drawing of a banjo player. But all the tabs just said, no thanks. And you could just tear one off.
I thought that
was so good.
That is good. Cheers to whoever put that up.
I know. I was like, that is a great idea.
Yeah. I'm going to start... Well, if we ever get our printer working, I'm going to print 100 of those out.
Yes, yeah. No, everyone knows a banjo joke and they give banjos a hard time. But at the same time, I know that everyone loves the banjo.
It's true.
So it's like,
it's true.
You can't take it personally.
Well, okay.
It's an easy instrument to
I can't say that every front of house audio guy loves the banjo.
Sure.
But I still love the banjo. I still love the banjo.
Oh, man.
It's funny whenever you're setting up, especially with like what you're mentioning, the resonator on like the bluegrass style.
Yeah.
Is it safe to say that's a bluegrass style?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All the other band members are always like, just make sure he's like standing in the back of the room because it's just so loud. It's like, right. Put him the furthest away from the microphone.
He doesn't need a mic.
He does. Yeah. Yeah.
It's just, if you could put a wall in front of him.
Yeah. Like the drum shield.
Exactly.
I've heard those called like the soul shield. Whatever. Oh, it just blocks all the sound out. Where do we want to go? Hop into another video? I feel like the next artist is appropriate to roll into from this conversation we're having, though he's not playing banjo in this particular video.
He's not.
But we have videos of him playing banjo
in the same space.
Yeah, same session.
That was this video. This is actually the first and only year I ever went to Rhythm and Roots.
Really?
I don't know why. It's always like a weekend that I can't make it or something comes up. But I was there for that one, and I knew you guys then, but I didn't know you that well. I think Stan Sharp had an in and was like, "You guys want to come watch some videos that the Live&Breathing's recording?" So I actually got to be in the room for this recording. I remember being there.
Cool.
And for a few others, I was like back, you know, out of the way. But yeah, I've been a big Willie Watson fan forever, and
he's great.
And man, his voice, like, we're going from the tiny little pump house to this humongous, what was this factory?
It
was
the L.C. King building where Pointer Brand is.
Oh, so my gosh.
It is the oldest, am I going to word this right? Hand sew factory. So since we were there, a few years, became friends with them and went and checked out the space when they were working and also when they were not working. But the denim comes in big rolls and everybody hand cuts out. You know, they have the format of, you know, if it's this size pants, you use this. If it's this shirt, you use this. Cut it all out, and then it's all handmade in the space. You can see all the sewing machines in the back and whatnot. And
that's amazing.
It's incredible. It really is incredible.
It was such a perfect space for these videos.
It didn't matter. Like, this is one dude.
Yeah.
Oh, looks and sounds awesome. And then we would have full bands in there, like St. Paul and the Broken Bones, and it also fit that perfectly. Yeah. You know, it's amazing.
I mean, his voice is huge, though. I feel like
he is
one guy in there singing to fill up that room. It was like
amazing.
Yeah.
He is so good at, he's really commanding of his audience. This is. He steps on stage and it's like, okay.
Yeah.
Here we go. Yeah. So here we go. You want to introduce it?
This is, well, is the full title Keep It Clean?
That's what I have it written down as.
Okay.
I believe that's correct.
I feel like it's longer than that, but I can't remember what the full title is.
we'll say Keep It Clean.
All right.
And I'll take the blame for
it. Willie Watson singing Keep It Clean.
Couldn't get across. Jumped on your papa cause I thought it was a horse. Now ride him over. Give him a Coca-Cola, lemon soda, saws of ice cream, take soap and water, fought to keep it clean. Well, up she jumped and down she fell. Her mouth flew open like a mussel shell. Now ride her over. Give her Coca-Cola, lemon soda, sauce of ice cream, take soap and water, for to keep it clean. D-I-E, got to put on your collar and your T-I-E. Now ride it over, give it a Coca-Cola, lemon soda, saws of ice cream, take soap and water, for to keep it clean. Hey, wanna get the rabbit out the L-O-G, got to put on a stump like a D-O-G. Now ride it over, give it a Coca-Cola, lemon soda, sauce of ice cream, take soap and water, for to keep it clean. Take him down to the river and wash his, yes, yes, yes. Now ride him over, give him a Coca-Cola, lemon soda, salt of ice cream, take soap and water for to keep it clean. So run here, doctor, run here fast. Tell me what's the matter with this yes, yes, yes now. Ride him over, give him a Coca-Cola, lemon soda, salt of ice cream, take soap and water for to keep it clean. Take soap and water for to keep it clean.
That guy. I've seen him a few times live with an audience, and he has that talent of, we were just talking about this, he steps on stage and commands the audience.
Yep.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
That is such a powerful thing to be able to do.
He's just all in all the time. Like, yeah. You can tell he's...
And everybody's engaged.
Never holding back at all. It's amazing.
Yeah. We were talking about... Also during the break, and also the St. Paul and the Broken Bones. I mentioned them of the many, many artists that we recorded in there.
Mm-hmm.
But a huge, something that we're really, really proud of is there was this show on HBO called Big Little Lies.
Mm-hmm.
And you just brought this up. And one of our St. Paul and the Broken Bones videos from that same space is playing on a TV in the background of one of the scenes.
Girls like dancing to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love that show. And I remember seeing that and being like, oh my gosh, I know that.
Yes.
I know those guys.
Were you there for that session also?
I was not there for that recording.
Okay.
For that, for the Broken Bones session. But
I want to bring up something.
But I knew the room. Yeah.
The space.
Yeah.
The amazing space. I want to bring up something that is about my family. So my father, he was a head coach in the NFL, and then after that he did some commentating and also drove a NASCAR in a few different series and a bunch of other series. But when he was doing the commentating, he was on this show on HBO called Inside the NFL. It was a bunch of other coaches and players and whatnot, and I think it was Sunday night after all the games happened, they would sit around and talk about NFL games, what happened that week and whatnot. And in the background of a Sopranos episode is my dad on this show.
Mm.
And so my dad says, like, every year he gets a check for that, and it's like 37 cents. So my question is to HBO, like, where's my 37
right?
cents or 12 cents for being in the background?
You guys aren't getting your 37 cents.
That's right. I bet St. Paul and the Broken Bones is getting that, actually. So...
Probably.
I'll talk to them about that.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's probably like $3 now. Just kidding.
Oh, man. No, you should be proud of that. It's really cool.
It's awesome.
To have that in there.
Yeah. The ways that, because we have over 1,000 videos.
Mm-hmm.
So I hear often of ways and the ways that our videos are used to either inspire or document or just be like, hey, this is I don't know why I was feeling about avoiding this, but I've been told a few times that there's this fellow, his name is Rick Rubin, and he is a huge music fan, which is completely obvious if you're familiar with him, but he has used or found not just Live&Breathing videos. I'm not saying that he only watches Live&Breathing videos, but some artists he has sent them Live&Breathing videos and be like, hey, like, we're working on this song and I really like this vibe or this version of the song or whatever it is. Like, he'll use it to reference.
Yeah.
And that is another thing that I'm super proud of.
Yeah.
Along the exact same lines of what you were saying about Chicken Pin Hunting.
Mm-hmm.
That, like, you use that video and, like, hey, let's learn this song. And that's the version of it that you dig. Just so thankful and so blessed to be able to capture those moments, because when I hear of the inspiration going beyond, it's just, it really makes life worth living. It's just one of those amazing things.
Yeah, so doing a
Thank
great,
you.
Doing a great thing here.
Trying.
Yeah.
Trying. It's just fun.
Yeah.
Nick and I, right now, Nick and I are the only people here aside from you. So it's basically a one-man show at this moment.
Right.
He's doing everything from cameras to switchers to audio, which is in the other room over here. Nick.
He's the master.
Thank you. You're doing awesome.
Way to go,
Love
Nick.
You too,
Love
bud.
You. You're doing great.
Oh, yeah. It's something that Nick always gets on me about is I always forget, because I don't like this when I'm watching YouTube videos and people say things, these things of like, turn on the notifications, click, like, follow. It's so important to say, and it's so important for the audience to do. Right. You have no idea, because something's got to pay for all of this. And we're riding a fine line right now, keeping it all going. So if you can do all of those things that you do on YouTube, click, follow, subscribe. If you didn't know that this is a live stream, right now we're live. You might be watching it in the future. But if you turn on notifications, you'll get a little notification when we're about to go live. And we anticipate creating a bunch of different shows in a bunch of different formats because we love doing it. Along those same lines, if you have any, not that anybody has any extra cash just jingling around that they want to throw out there, but if you enjoy the show and enjoy Live and Breathing and our thousand plus videos, go to Patreon and search Live and Breathing. It's real simple. You'll find our little logo. Click on it. You can either donate or you can subscribe. There's different tiers. I don't know how familiar anybody is with Patreon, but that is really helping us out also right now. And we're barely cutting the line right now, keeping everything going. But once we get over that line, we're going to have a new show. And we've got a few ideas and plans for it. And we're just going to keep making cooler things.
Yeah.
The Appalachian String Inn is the heart of it all. Again, this is our host of the Appalachian String Inn, Jessica Watson. And I always forget to mention this, too. At the end of the show, you're going to perform a song.
That's what I hear.
Do you know what song you're going to play?
Yeah. Cool. It's one that I wrote a couple of years ago that I haven't recorded it or anything. It's just
until now
floating around. I guess till now, yeah.
Boom, killing it. Another Man. First.
We'll see if I kill it. I don't know.
I'm sure. I have no doubt. What do you want to talk about? What do you want to do? You want to hop into the next video, or you want to?
Well, sure. Yeah, I've been watching your old videos for years, but and you've been gracious enough to record some of the projects I've been a part of in the past.
That is easy.
Cheese and Rosin, and
yes,
when I was playing with John Whitlock Trio and all that. So
Legbeard
most recently. Yep. Yeah, that band, everyone, like, we have no social media presence, no internet presence at all. It's just like, if you're not in town and you don't know me or Daniel Kimbrough or Meat Armstrong, it's like, Legbeard, what's that?
I think
kind of fun.
Daniel's come up, and I've bragged on Daniel almost every episode, I think. Yeah. And I do my best to brag on Mead because it's so easy to do.
Mm-hmm.
I got to bring it up again. Mother's Daughter Bread.
Yeah.
Look it up, find it out. She has been working so hard to make, I hope that I'm not wording this wrong for her, but I feel like she's trying to make that her profession, baking.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And she's been working so hard for many years towards that, and watching her grow and her abilities of baking, it is amazing and absolutely delicious.
Yeah.
Do you have anything to add to that? I wish we had some of the bread right now, or the cookies, or anything that she makes.
Yeah, I just popped into her new space for a second last night, and she was working on some stout loaf.
Awesome.
That she was, had I don't remember specifically which beer she had in there, but it was like, this looks and smells really good.
Mm-hmm.
But she's got her new space that'll hopefully be open in the next, I don't know, month or two or something.
What is this space like?
Storefront? She's over in South Knoxville.
Okay.
That new Baker Creek, that old church over there.
She's in that?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah. I love that space.
So she's got a little room in the bottom floor over there that's in the works. So it's functioning now, but it's not like open to the public. Yeah.
That makes me so happy.
Yeah. So she's doing back at the markets downtown for now, and then she'll be doing other collaborative stuff over there too.
What a great location for her.
I know. I'm so happy for her. she's been working toward something like this for years.
Yes.
So it's like really
yes.
exciting. But yeah.
And it's
this
so
is why
stressful.
I can't ever get her to play gigs with me anymore. She's too busy making bread.
Well, I don't even know what to say about that.
No, I know. It's like, fine. I get it. I support it. I do.
Of course. How amazing and fun is it? I've most of the time when I experience and witness this growth and this effort that people put into it, it's in a band. Like when I see the band start to build a draw and, you know, start to gain a following, it is so... I don't know. It's just so much. I feel so proud to just be a part of just witnessing it. Mm-hmm. But with Mead, it's baking.
Yeah.
And
she's great.
So
she's
proud of her.
Multi-talented.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I was admiring your shoes. I was like, those are really awesome shoes.
Yep.
And you brought up Mead because she got them for you. But I hopped in and I was like, well, what, did she make those for you too?
Oh, pfft.
This is...
No, I did just recently give her my old sewing machine because I've had it for a long time and never use it.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, hey, Merry Christmas.
There's something else for you to do. Yeah.
So if you have, you know, any spare time and you want to start sewing.
Also, here's some pants and some shirts that you could also...
I just need a little work.
Does she do that also?
Time. Does she do that? Does she sew? I mean, I think she's done a little bit, but not like...
Not like her baking?
No.
Okay.
Not put that kind of energy into it yet. But no, she found these at a thrift store for me and knows that it's
that's cool.
Right up my alley for shoe wear.
Knoxville.
It's a good friend to have, yeah.
The art scene, all the makers, I just love the city so much and it's growing. And most of the time I think that that's kind of what I like about a place that can be a bad thing. But I feel like the growth here is really healthy and really also supporting. It's not pushing all these creators out. Mm-hmm. It's really supporting them.
Yeah.
And I know I have a list of people that come to mind when I think about that. I'm only going to name one, and his name is John Phillips. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to have him on here one day.
Good.
He's built banjos. He's built amazing banjos. But that's not what he's doing now. He's making knives.
Right.
And over the pandemic... There was no touring or no shows, and he took me in and employed me and taught me how to make knives from scratch. So I'm really looking forward to that episode when that happens.
That's great. Oh, his stuff's beautiful.
It's
it's
amazing. It is top notch.
Yeah.
Beautiful knives. John Phillips.
Yeah. He mounted the that mic inside my banjo.
Yeah.
That pickup in there for me.
Yeah. He's also built a lot of, like, he can do anything. He's built some of the bars, like the countertops around town that are just, like, really cool, tons of character. The shelves at the chop shop, I help him make. I don't know if you, they're this beautiful, thick slab, rough cut wood with these amazing, L brackets that hold up these really heavy shelves. The guy can do anything, and the town is full of people like that, and I'm so proud to live here and be a part of it, and it just feels great.
Yeah, it's a great spot for creative folk around here. It's really nice, and everyone's very supportive of each other. But as I was looking back at some of the interviews you've done before this, I was like trying to pick out, you know, my favorite videos. And I'm glad I looked back at some of the previous ones because Rodney Lee took one that I wanted to use.
Which one did he take?
Alan and Amanda had one. Well, I knew I wanted one of the Lake Street Dive videos. And I was like, oh man, that rich girl is just so great.
It is.
And then I got on Rodney's and was like, ah, Rodney.
Blast.
He beat me to it. But yeah, it's back in that pump house.
Yep.
They're
that's where we're going right now.
They're amazing.
And
like, I don't know, like it's just such a simple, little 4-piece thing, and they have such a big sound and everyone's doing so much at once.
Yeah.
Just perfectly. And you're like, oh, this is a band full of people who are clearly, trained in music and have studied music and
played together for a long time.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this song in particular, I'm just like, how are they switching between these time signatures so seamlessly? This song is so cool.
That and also the way that they fill space with each instrument in not normal ways that the instrument would be used. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'm wording that right, but like Rachel's voice sometimes is just filling the space of where the piano or something like that could be. And Bridget is kind of like an electric guitar, and the electric guitar is kind of like the rhythm sometimes. And then like McDuck on the trumpet, I don't think that he tours with the band anymore, but such a phenomenal musician on the trumpet and electric guitar. Mm-hmm. And then Mike on the drums and their harmonies. This is a powerhouse band.
Absolutely.
Powerhouse band.
I remember before they were big, I saw them on the Blue Plate special one day.
Wow.
On that tiny little stage.
Holy cow.
And I think this was years and years ago where I was kind of in that phase where I was thinking, people who just get up and sing and they're not playing an instrument. Come on, get out of here. But then it was really like I was kind of in that mindset, and I saw this band on the Blue Plate and was like, that girl, her voice is her instrument.
That's how you do it.
She is incredible.
Yeah.
I love it so much. Everything about
this. Right quick, define the Blue Plate special for those who don't know.
Oh, so we have a local radio station here in Knoxville, WDVX, every day except for Sundays.
Saturdays too?
Saturdays.
I don't know that I knew that. I thought it was Monday through Friday.
So it's Saturday. Fridays, it's moved over to Barley's in the Old City. It's back back in the Visitor Center on Saturdays. But yeah, cool. Monday through Saturday, noon to 1.
And how much does it cost to go check this out?
It is a free show.
Walk in the door and you're in it.
Yeah, yep. So if you're visiting Knoxville and you're like, I want to hear some live music, walking around during the day, you can just
after breakfast.
There. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Which is great places to eat downtown,
too. Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, let's hop into this video.
So this is Lake Street Dive performing 17.
You will enjoy it.
Feel it.
that band
killer.
Killer. Yeah. Absolute killer. Like they always blow me away. Yeah. They now have a slightly different setup. I haven't seen them in a few years. But the Avett Brothers and Lake Street Dive, we've done many shows together, and I love those bills. I've mentioned this before. From the band to the crew, everybody is awesome, and everybody is easy to work with and fun and just happy to be there.
That's so important, too.
It is so important. Yeah. That adds so much longevity to a career in music, which is already pretty ruthless and gruesome at times, you know. Oh, we got a few people. I still need my glasses that I don't have. I need to go to the eye doctor. What is that?
M Ninja?
Forf. Love trying to pronounce that.
I know.
I'm sure we just butchered that.
Probably.
But good morning to you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Paul Tucci, always out there. Thank you so much. Paul brought up a great point. What is it like, Jessica Watson, to be married to Willie Watson?
Oh, well, I mean... well, he's a good-looking
distant
man.
He's good-looking. That's your brother!
Oh, wait. Yeah, that's right. I couldn't remember how we were related. Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
Now, is there any relation for real?
There is not, unfortunately. Yeah.
Not surprised. I don't know why I said I'm not surprised. You guys are both such talented musicians.
No,
have you ever hung out with him? Or
never. I haven't had the pleasure of meeting him.
Very, very kind.
Just been an admirer.
Are you familiar with his acting? Have you heard about this?
No.
He was in the Coen Brothers. Oh, my gosh. Shoot. They did a series of shorts.
What you're talking about. Buster
Scruggs.
Yeah, yeah. With our minds combined,
we're going to get through this, Jessica. We're going to do it, which is awesome. I don't know if you've watched that.
I have heard great things, and I haven't seen it yet. I need to go back.
There's also, now I'm spacing on his name. We were just talking about this, how I space on names. very, very rough voice. He's a beat poet. He's an actor. His shows are one of a kind. I've never seen him live, but somebody that I really want to see. Oh my gosh. In that movie.
Rollins.
Who?
Rollins?
No. If you've seen the movie The Book of Eli, he works in the little shop. It's gonna come to me. Anywho, he's like the only actor in another part of that series that we just mentioned of the Coen brothers. And oh my gosh, it's killing me. I can't think of his name.
It'll come to you as soon as we're not thinking about it anymore.
I want to throw the word pirate music out there because that's one of his albums is very similar to that. Okay, anywho. Where do we go from here, Jessica? Steer the ship now.
I have no idea. I'm not married to Willie Watson. He's also not my brother.
But he is attractive. I think we can agree on that. Yeah. That's a handsome young man right there.
Attractive qualities. man. Paul Tucci. Oh, he's thinking. He's helping you.
Eli, no. The movie is The Book of Eli. This is a very well-known, more for his performances and his albums. What is it? The old 65 is one of his songs.
Let it go.
I'm letting it go. I'm letting it go. And we're moving on now.
Yeah.
Letting it go.
We'll get on the internet when this is over.
Yeah, during this next song break, I'm definitely going to... And then we're going to be like, oh yeah, duh, of course.
Of course.
Okay, so we've talked about how amazing Knoxville is in the artist community, which I will try to bring up every episode because I just love this town. But in that, and the wealth... the girth of talent that is here. There is one of the sweetest men, one of my dearest friends, and you have picked one of his songs to be next. And this video is also captured in Knoxville in the Regis building, which is now, they didn't tear it down, but they rebuilt it and turned it into a few things, which also now houses one of my favorite places to eat in Knoxville, Potchke.
That was... Pachi was recently named like one of the best restaurants in the U.S.
In the U.S.?
I think it was like, I don't remember which
I know that I magazine. Say that, but who else said that?
But it was like, it's some like well-known magazine. I can't remember which one. But people are hearing about it, which is great. It's fantastic.
What's your favorite thing to get there?
I usually get like, I get the potato blintz thing.
Really? Yeah. I've forgotten that once. It was awesome.
Oh, man.
I can't steer away from the lox bialy. The salmon and everything bagel, everything about that.
You
and
get
the
showstopper. A shot of that beet juice stuff that they make.
I have not had that.
Mm.
I'm going to get that.
Yeah.
Have you had the showstopper? Have you seen that?
I don't think so.
It's like a white fish salad on two of the most delicious thick cut pieces of white bread. Mm. The sandwich is enormous, but oh my gosh, it is.
Yeah.
The reason I don't get it all the time is because of how big it is.
Oh, sure. And share it with somebody.
No, share it with somebody. I don't want to eat.
Like, I'm a man. I don't Hold share on a second. Food.
When the food hits the table, if you're with a group of friends, do you pick off your other, like, oh, I'd like to try that. Are you that kind of person?
I'll go out to eat with friends, and we're like, what do we want to share? Or if we can't decide, well, I'll get this, you get that. And we'll just kind of like.
See, I love.
It's a planned sharing,
I
typically.
I love that and respect that. But when
or
the food,
I'll bring my own to-go box, knowing that I won't finish something.
But then you won't share it then?
I mean, like, if I'm not planning on sharing, I'm like, this is going to be too much food. I'm prepared to have leftovers.
Okay.
Yeah.
You bring your own to-go box?
I do that sometimes.
I've never heard of that. That is amazing. I love that. I need to start doing that because I get the open-faced lox bialy, knowing I'm going to eat half then and bring the rest home later.
We got it all figured out.
I bring my own bags to the grocery store.
Yeah. What's the difference?
What's the difference?
Yeah.
Woo. Next level. Okay. Back to the sweetest human being on earth.
Musicians. Yeah. This is three very sweet, wonderful, talented Knoxville musicians in this video.
No doubt. And one of them, I think I meant to add this up, but I think that John Whitlock has been in the most Live and Breathing videos of anybody else.
As I was narrowing mine down, there was a moment where he was in half of them.
He's going to be on the show sitting where you're sitting a week from today.
Yeah, good. I just saw him a couple of days ago. He mentioned it.
Oh.
Yeah, he's the best.
He is a beautiful human being of all, for so many reasons. But one of my favorites is, beyond his drumming, is storytelling.
Yeah.
I think that he is such a great storyteller. And then when he started playing his own songs out, it completely made sense.
Yeah.
It's just like, his songs are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
His spirit is so sweet and amazing. And he's just, I've not been able to hang out that much because, you know, you have kids and the nightlife kind of disappears with that.
Sure.
But he is one of the people that I really miss hanging out with and spending time with. Just such a great person. So he's on drums.
Mm-hmm.
Taylor Coker is on the upright bass. Another sweetheart. I don't know him that well, but every time I'm around him or his brother, they're just amazing.
Yeah.
And they're not twins?
They're not, but they look very similar.
I always thought that they were twins, and then somebody told me they weren't.
Yeah.
We're not.
Very musical family, and that's amazing as well.
Yeah. But, what other musical families can you think of from this town?
In this town?
One immediately pops into mind, which is the Mullikens.
Oh,
Clint and Chuck.
Oh, Clint, absolutely.
Back to that Redeemer album. I had never met Clint before. And so, like, Ben Bannister, he was kind of the producer, and he had different musicians coming in to play on different songs. And Clint comes into the church, is where we track most of it. And Ben hands him, you know, the music, and Clint looks at it. He's like, all right, cool. And he, like, sets it down. And first take, the most tasteful. I don't even think he was looking at it while he was playing.
Yep.
Like, he just, like, scanned over. He's like, okay, cool. And from then on, I was like, wow. And then I saw baseball play, which they don't play anymore. Did you ever see them play?
Yeah, yeah.
So it was Clint on electric in that mm-hmm. band, and his brother playing Chuck. Saxophone, Chuck.
Man.
Holy cow.
He's a powerhouse, too.
Yeah.
He really, like, I don't know if I've ever seen anyone play sax the way that Chuck plays.
No, no. Just recorded so him great. In here for working on an album with Sam Quinn.
Oh, cool.
And Chuck is on it, and very similar to Clint, and it's just like, let's just roll it. And it's just like,
yeah.
you do like three or four takes yeah. of keepers, and now the hardest part is like picking the best, the shiniest diamond.
Or, right.
You know, it's just like, yeah. man, these are all awesome. Great yeah. problem to have.
Oh, absolutely. And then, I mean, we've already mentioned Daniel, but the Kimbros, another
That's
musical
right.
family. Corey's working on new stuff.
Corey, the record holder holding fisherman.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It came up, I think, with a couple episodes ago, because Daniel is, the whole family, avid fisherman.
Mm-hmm.
And I know Daniel, well, I know Daniel pretty well. His brother, Corey, I don't know that well. I don't know that we've ever had sat down together and had a whole conversation. But I'm very aware of him and his musical abilities. And I've seen him play many times. And but knowing how passionate Daniel is about fishing, and that Daniel took me out on his boat and we didn't catch anything. And then also knowing that his brother holds a record and Daniel doesn't, I think that's very funny. And I'm sure Daniel is going to defriend me and
You're like,
I'm like
sure
just
Daniel
cut me off.
Daniel doesn't find it as funny.
No, he's gonna, my number, when he watches this, or the past episode too, because I brought it up, my number will be blocked on his phone.
No.
Not at all.
He'll be like, challenge accepted. I got to work harder.
That's right.
Yeah.
And he will be that way too, which he's also so dedicated
I
everything.
But yeah.
Oh, the Kimbros.
I don't even know if we said Josh Oliver's name.
No, we're just talking about
random we're talking about his band, but this is Josh Oliver, one of his tunes.
Yeah. Are we going into the song right now?
Sure.
Are you ready for that?
I mean, this was another one where I was trying to narrow down which Josh Oliver mm-hmm. video to go with, because you have a few on there, and they're all amazing, and the stuff he does with Jill.
Yep.
Alan and Amanda took one of the ones that I was thinking about.
Did they?
I was like, okay, as long as it's on here somewhere. But their harmonies are amazing. This is... He wrote this one, right? Is this one of his?
I believe so.
I think it's one of his.
I don't like claiming that because there's so many times I've thought that somebody wrote a song and then I find out it's like a traditional song or somebody else wrote it.
But I think he's so good at... Like, his writing mm-hmm. sounds like... His songs sound like traditional songs.
Yes.
Kind of like a Gillian Welch, Dave Rawlings effect where you're like, has this song just been around forever? Or did
Very
they
timeless.
Write this?
Yeah.
He's got that.
And this performance of that song too
yeah.
is, I feel the same
so
way.
So great. He's got one of my favorite voices in town or anywhere.
What a sweet, handsome man.
Yeah. I'm picking all the handsome men for my
That's
video.
Oh, is that the theme? Hold on a second. I haven't put that
That's
together.
That's not true, but there's two of them now.
Okay. Well, the last one, too, is like,
I know, right?
All right.
No, Josh anywho. Is the best.
So are we going to, do you want to introduce it? I haven't introduced one. Do you want me to, or do you want to?
Go for it. I'll let, yeah.
Okay.
Why don't you do it?
This is Josh Oliver performing Heartbroken Blues. No, I've messed it up. You do it.
Lonesome Heartbroken?
Lonesome, yeah.
Yeah.
Damn it. I'm sorry, Josh. Jessica, you do it right. You got this.
Yeah. Oh, do I need to say it again?
Yeah, say it again.
Josh Oliver performing Lonesome Brokehearted. Oh, my God.
Okay. My
Broken
turn.
Hearted
Back and
Blues.
Forth.
Jeez.
Josh
Can
Oliver.
Can we splice this together?
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to read it first. Josh Oliver performing Lonesome Heartbroken Blues.
Well, they found me all alone. I was moaning some sad, lonesome song. More than a few teardrops had flown. somehow broken blue. Another rain comes and it goes. Well, I try to explain, but nobody knows. Lonesome, heartbroken blue. Searching for a home where sorrow is gone and heartbreak there'll be none there too. I guess I'll run around every bar in this town until I stop thinking about you and these lonesome heartbroken.
Indeed. That was an incredible video.
Yeah.
We've already talked about how what a sweet group of young men that is.
Very talented.
And they're all from Knoxville.
Yep.
They all play in countless bands. That's a fact. And I'm not sure what else to say about them. John's going to be on a week from today. We already said that. And I can't remember. Right now I'm spacing out because we were talking about this while the video was playing. Did I mention on air what a great storyteller John is?
Yeah.
I did. That was live. That wasn't off. Okay.
I think so.
Now we're getting
it's
redundant.
All running together, but yeah.
It is running together.
And it's true.
This coffee that I'm drinking is very strong.
Is it?
It is heart coffee. It's a light roast. I don't think that you nerd out on coffee. I tried not to, but I think it's getting older that I really just enjoy a good cup of coffee.
Yeah.
And I keep this one here because my wife and I, she's not as picky about coffee. We have a dark roast in the morning, which is less caffeine. And I just look forward to getting to the studio and making this cup of coffee, and it's really kicking in.
Nice. Is this a K-brew?
Yours is a K-brew decaf.
Yeah. I haven't had their decaf, so it's good.
It's good?
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The old pour-over, it came through.
Yeah. And this was specially ground.
Oh, that's right. So coffee grinder is not here in the house today. And I thought that decaf...
I thought that meant game over, but you were like...
Oh, no. I'll make it happen. There is, you know, okay, so there's a cabinet over there of different kinds of beverages, mm-hmm. adult beverages. And I don't know if you, if people are aware of this, but, you know, different bottles have a different bottom. And if you don't have a coffee grinder, the glass is thick, and some of them have the, a great shape to, you kind of roll the bottom over the coffee beans. And I use one of my, my favorites, the Four Roses bottle, and I ground your coffee bean, your decaf coffee beans.
Damn.
Because I selfishly brought a jar of my, of this coffee ground, because there's not a grinder here, and I need to get a grinder here.
Well, I also didn't give you any warning that I don't drink real coffee.
We texted, and you said, and you asked about it, and but in my mind, I'm like, yeah, there's decaf there, and I thought that this was pre-ground.
Yeah, if I was drinking regular coffee, I'd be sitting over here like.
Yeah, we had talked about
the
that.
Shakes. So
I have my
body can't handle it.
One of my dearest friends, I'm not going to call him out by name on this, but I travel with him. I love him. He is, him and his family are huge parts of my life and my family's life. And I consider him and his family part of my family. But I've known him for a very long time. And he used to drink a lot of coffee. And visually, his hand would start, this. And I could always tell, like, when we're working or whatever, like, he'd reach for something. Mm. And I was like, how much coffee have you had? And so he kind of learned that, and it was like, okay, cutting out the coffee, which was a big deal. He also, at one point, when we met, he owned a coffee shop in Greensboro. Coffee has always been a very large part of his life, as it is for many people. And he's like, all right, I'm cutting out coffee, and he drank tea. Mm-hmm. And he kind of turned me on to drinking tea, which is a great, I think I just really love the hot fluid.
Yes.
And especially late at night is such a great thing. I've learned the joy of a decaffeinated tea at night is amazing.
Yeah.
So then he switches to tea and the shakes go away. Then last year or so, he takes a trip to Italy and discovers espresso. And he's like, I'm gonna, you know, I enjoy a little espresso, but I want to take it easy. Mm-hmm. And now we're working together. He'll literally have like four or five a day, and he's completely back on it. And I'm like, bud, I thought you were taking it easy on the caffeine. Okay. We're gonna shift gears to another dear friend who always comes in with the answers. He is one of the sweetest men. He's the sweetest man that I know, one of. He is a huge inspiration on my life and my career. He is a retired audio engineer. And when I had my son in September, he filled in to mix the Avett Brothers for me. And aside from that, has just inspired me in many different ways. But he chimed in, and yes, it was Tom Waits that I could not find the name of.
Yeah.
But
Paul knows.
Paul knows how to use Google.
one of his many talents.
But yeah, that Coen Brothers, amazing. Willie Watson's amazing in it, in his section. Tom Waits is amazing in his section. I love Tom Waits' acting. He always plays these goofy little quirky characters that just take the whole movie away. Checks in the mail, Paul.
Yeah, I got to get on that and watch that so we can talk about it.
Please do.
Yeah.
I have no dog in that fight, but I find it to be very special and very inspiring. A lot of things the Coen Brothers do. Yeah. Very big fan of them. What do you want to do, Jessica? Is there anything you want to talk about that we have not talked about? Do you have any shows or recordings or anything coming out that you want to promote and talk about?
I mean, I've been playing mostly these days with a group called Blue Ridge Gathering.
Whoa.
Me and...
tell me about that.
Me and Cody Bauer, fiddle player, and Duck Ryan, who also plays guitar and banjo.
Oh, cool. Yep. And he was on an Appalachian String Inn?
Yeah.
Both of them.
Yeah. So we've been pretty active recently. We're just about to start recording an EP and get songs
that's exciting.
Out there. So that's like, that would be, yeah, that's like what I'm staying busy with these days. And
Original
look,
songs?
Look us up. It's a combination. We do a handful of originals and we do some fiddle tunes and we do some covers, but we try to make the covers sound like us.
Uh-huh.
And we do some like some Gillian Welch stuff, and we do did you ever the band Real Time Travelers, did you ever hear that band?
No.
It's like it's very old time, but we've taken a couple of their songs and kind of made them a little funky, sort of. That's too strong of a word, but we're kind of messing around with those, and it's super fun. And
cool,
those guys are great musicians, and we do some really interesting things with those three instruments. Cody is like, he's got the full pedal board for his fiddle, so he likes to do a lot of like,
oh
spacey,
wow,
reverb-y
plugged
kind of
in
stuff, and yeah.
Do you put any effect? What are you playing in it?
Mostly banjo with these guys. And
any
some
effects
guitar.
Or anything?
Nah.
Okay.
Nah.
Nah.
I never got into the pedal game. It's like, that's a whole other instrument to learn.
It
how
really
to
is.
Use all that stuff. So yeah. I just haven't done it. But it's cool. I love hearing what sounds people can get.
You can make a guitar sound like a goat. You know?
Right? It's like,
anything you want to do.
I haven't had a need for that yet. We'll
it's
get there.
It's you know it's a rare need, but it's possible. I think that's
sure.
the point.
That's the point. You can do whatever you want. But yeah, that's fun. So Blue Ridge Gathering, look us up.
Blue Ridge Gathering.
We're new, but we're getting our sound together. It's been really fun.
If you ever want to make some videos,
sure.
I know a guy.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, let's do that. Okay. Got you. You confirmed it on air. Holding you to it. Well, should we go into the last video?
Probably, yeah.
Okay.
This is a songwriter who I've been admiring for years. And in my own writing, I tend to, because I listen to a lot of different styles, and I tend to kind of, go between... different. I don't think I have like a clear path in my writing. It doesn't. One will sound like jazzy, and the next one is like a Kleinheimer banjo tune. And
that is this, amazing.
It's I love it, and I don't feel like I'm tied to a certain genre.
That's so special. Yeah.
So I can do whatever I feel like in the moment, but it does make it a little harder when it's like, I might want to record, but I'm like, do these even make sense back to back on an album? I don't know.
Don't ever worry about that.
I know what you mean. I shouldn't, but it's.
You're overthinking it. Just let it come out and it'll be what it is.
It can be whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's her. This is Anias Mitchell, the last video. Her writing is so beautiful, and I love the language that she uses, and her voice, everything is so unique.
That's what I was going to talk about. This keeps happening on the show, is that I forget about videos that we've recorded, and I'd forgotten about these, and watched it last night, and also whenever you sent me the list of the videos, complete chills, like the first, first quarter to half of that song, I was just taken away to another place.
Man.
And it's just, I'm so excited that you brought this back out and to share this, because if you don't get chills, write a comment about it. If you do get chills, send this to somebody else and share it.
It's such a great song. She's been fresh on my mind too, because I went with Alan and Amanda to see the musical that she wrote. Hadestown has been at the Tennessee Theater. It was a couple weeks ago.
Yes.
Fantastic.
You just connected a couple dots because I knew that I had been hearing about her recently, mm-hmm. and I wasn't, that's what it was.
Yeah.
What an incredibly talented human being.
Yeah. I love everything she does. And the song I'm going to do later is like, if I could compare it to something, to someone or their style, I would like it to, if I could get like, whenever I do record it with a full band, I'd like it to have sort of a quality of her style. Like,
cool.
Yeah. That's kind of what I hear is like her Young Man in America, that whole album is just like, has a sound that I'm like, I want to try for that on like one song of mine.
That's awesome.
It's one of my favorite albums like of all time.
I'm going to dive into that. Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah. I highly recommend it.
This is one of the first sessions that we ever recorded, I believe. Like Live and Breathing had just kind of started. I want to say this was our first, maybe second year at Pickathon. You got a fan out there.
Oh, hey, Red.
You're a badass. She said that yesterday, too.
Thanks, Red. Back at you.
Woo! Oh, Ross. Ross was at this session. He's a dear friend who lives in Portland, and he would come out and help us out at Pickathon. Just a part of the heart of the pick or of the Live and Breathing team. Thank you for being here, Ross. Thanks for everything. Miss you. Should we just hop into it? And then after this, you're going to perform a song, and then that's the end of the show.
Sounds good.
We're back here at the sad point of the end.
This is Anias Mitchell performing Coming Down.
Don't leave me right now. stop me now. Nothing gonna stop me now.
I have the chills. There's one line in there, or one pair of words. I'm not even going to get into that, because then it's going to start a huge conversation, and I need to be closing down the show. I hope you all...
I want to know, what's the line that...
Well, I also kind of... I don't want to get it wrong, but I believe the two words were easy feeling.
Oh, yeah.
And
easy feeling,
yeah, but just like where it comes from into that phrase and where it goes from that phrase, I don't know why that stuck out to me, but it beyond the chills, it made the chills deeper,
yeah,
or the hair stuck up further.
That song just kind of creates an emotion for me. It just puts me in a place of like, oh, I've been here,
yeah,
and I've been there. And this song that I'm going to play is kind of, there aren't a lot of words in it, but it's sort of like, this is a place I've been in, a moment where I've had a feeling, and yeah, just had to put it on an instrument. But yeah. Yeah, this is a song called Keep It That Way.
Having so much fun and was so so happy. Thanks, Jessica.
And then I ruined it.
I'm no, so ruined it is not the right word. That was beautiful. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jessica.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
thank you for being here. Thank you for the enormous role you're playing in Live and Breathing and where we're at right now.
I'm so grateful you guys asked me to be a part of
it. It was an easy decision.
All that, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you all out there for tuning in, for spreading the word. If you liked any part of this or any of our other episodes, please share them with your friends. This is all kind of new to us. We're getting it together. We're building the crew here in the studio, and we're all working really, really hard. And the one thing that we need, money. So if you have the time and the ability to go onto Patreon and make a donation or subscribe or help out any way you can. If you can't, then just help spread the word. Post this on your social medias. Follow us on YouTube. Turn on your notifications. Like it. Dislike it. Let us know how you feel. If you have constructive criticism, we want to make everything better. We want to give the audience what they want. And if there's any way we can shape this differently or change anything, or if you have an idea for a show, anything, just let us know. We are here to make things that you guys want to watch and to inspire you and to bring joy and happiness to your life and to make life better for yourselves and everybody around you. I could go on about that for forever, but I'm not going to because this is the end of the show. So with a huge heart, thank you so much. And also, don't ride in the left lane on the interstate. It's for passing. You get in that lane to pass somebody,
thank you.
Then get over. I feel like I say this just about every episode, and there's a reason I say it, because I'm a very, very happy person until that happens. So on that note, Jessica, thank you. Everybody, thank you. Justin. Nick.
Thanks, Nick.
Thanks, Nick. Cheers, everybody. I hope you have a wonderful day. And thank you. Nothing but love. See y'all next time.